द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी बाय खुशवंत सिंह। लेट मी स्टार्ट द लेसन। माई ग्रैंड मदर, लाइक एवरीबॉडीज ग्रैंड मदर, वॉज एन ओल्ड वुमेन। शी हैड बीन ओल्ड एंड रिंकल्ड फॉर द 20 years दैट आई हैड नोन हर। सो हियर खुशवंत सिंह, ही इज नरेटिंग अबाउट हिज मदर एंड ही इज सेइंग दैट माई मदर वॉज वेरी 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 ओल्ड। She had been old and wrinkled for the last 20 years that I had known her. So since the child has had known about his grandmother, he has found her as it is. Means for the last 20 years, he had been finding her grandmother exactly in the same figure as she was looking to him now. People said she had once been young and pretty. And had even a husband. So he is saying that people used to say that she has been very beautiful in her young age. And she also had a husband, but that was hard to believe because the child could not believe that she also had a husband. He has only seen her grandmother exactly in the same manner as he is seeing now. But my grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. Mantelpiece, children, it is a sort of slab which you used to find in the huge bungalows and in the huge kotis where the fireplace is there, and there is a slab upon it. Over there they used to keep some picture or huge picture of kings and queens or princes for some decoration. So over there on the mantelpiece there was a huge picture of the grandfather of this boy who wore a big turban and loose fitting clothes. Now the boy is describing his grandfather who was having a very very long turban and very very, very loose fitting clothes. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest and he looked as if at least 100 years old. So by his appearance he was looking very 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 old man. He did not look a sort of person who would have a wife or children. So by looking at the personality, it was assessed that he was only having grandchildren. He looked as if he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. As for my grandmother, being young and pretty, the thought was almost revolting. So the boy is saying, because my grandmother was very beautiful, so I could not believe that she could have a husband. It means it seemed that he was only having a grandchildren. She often told us the games she used to play as a child. Children, in those days it was a very very popular term that children used to tell stories to children used to listen stories from their grandparents. So this grandmother also used to tell story to this boy, and mostly she used to tell the games she used to play in her childhood. That seemed quite absurd and undignified on her part, but we treated it like the fables of the prophets she used to tell us. So these children used to listen the stories, fables means stories, with a moral. So prophets means the God who had come upon this earth as an incarnation of gods, as Lord Ram, Lord Krishna, Lord Buddha, Guru Nanak Dev, all these, right? She used to tell us. So these children, you used to listen the stories of the grandmother just thinking that they are the stories of prophets, right? Now, second paragraph. She always had been short and fat and slightly bent. Now, the second paragraph is describing the whole character sketch of Dadima, right? Grandmother. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. So his face was thorough, filled with the wrinkles all around. And no, we were certain that she had always been as we had known her old, and so terribly old that she could not have grown older and had stayed at the same age for the last 20 years. The boy has found this grandmother for the last 20 years in the same manner. And she could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. So here pretty and beautiful are defined in two different terms. Pretty means outside beauty, and beautiful means beautiful by heart. The grandmother was very beautiful, and she hobbled about the house in the spotless white one sari, one hand resting on the waist to balance her stoop, and the other to hold the beads of a rosary. So all the time she used to hobble, means jump or walk in the courtyard, by wearing white spotless sari, means ultimately pure white sari, right? And her one hand was basically resting on the waist, and the other hand is used to hold the rosary. Rosary means the string which we use to just count the beads in our worship, right? Her silver locks were scattered all around her face, her pale puckered face. Her silver locks, her grey hair, they were all scattered all around her face. And the face was also very white, pure white. Puckered face means wrinkled face. And her lips constantly moved in the prayer. All the time, she used to tell us the prayer, and inaudible means which cannot be listened by anybody. Yes, she was beautiful. Even then, the boy is appreciating her grandmother and saying that she was very beautiful. She was like the white winter landscape in the mountain, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. So children, when we go to the landscape and when we just view the mountain covered with snow, we get the peace in the mind. So just to look at the face of the grandmother, it was felt by the boy that she was the beautiful white peace, tranquility, feeling tranquility upon her face, and which was just showing the contentment, right? My grandmother and I were good friends. So here the boy, he is having very good relation with his grandmother. When he was a young boy, so his parents left him with her when they went to live in the city, and we were constantly together. So this boy was left behind in the village, and the parents have come to city for settling their career. So this boy was having constant relation with his grandmother. She used to wake me up in the morning and get me ready for the school. So the grandmother used to do all the things as our mother do, right? So she used to wake me up in the morning and get ready for the school. She said her morning prayer in a monotonous sing song while she bathed and dressed me, in the hope that this would listen and get to know it by heart. So it was a practice of the olden times ladies that they used to sing bhajans, and they used to sing religious songs or devotional songs in the morning, so that they used to think that the whole family will learn them. So here also Dadima was having the same feeling, but thinking that this boy will also learn. But this boy is saying that I listened because I love her voice and never bothered to learn it. He was not a very aesthetic type of boy. Then she would give me fetch my wooden slate, and that she had already washed and plastered with the yellow chalk, the tiny earthen ink pot, and the red pen tied to it. So in the evening she used to prepare everything for this boy, so that when he will go to the school, he will just require all these things. The wooden slate, she used to just make it ready in the evening. Then she used to also tie earthen pot in which she used to put red ink with a pen, so that this thing will be used by the boy in the school. Tie them up in the bundle and handed it to me. After a breakfast of thick stale chapatis, so you see, she used to cook chapatis in the evening only, and in the morning those chapatis will be given to this boy, along with putting a little butter and sugar on it, and this boy used to eat as a breakfast. We went to school. So after this, we went to school, means Dadima and the boy, they used to go to school together. Children, in our education system, no grandparents used to accompany us. But in the villages, all the temples were associated, all the religious places were associated to the schools. So she carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. So while going to the temple, She used to carry so many steel chapatis for the village dogs as well. My grandmother always went to school with me because my school was attached to the temple, as I told you. The priest taught us the alphabet and the morning prayer. So in those days, schools were associated behind the temples or the mosque or the churches or any gurdwaras, because in those days it was a feeling of people that our children should learn our religious education also, right? The priest taught us the alphabet and the morning prayer. So it was a job of priest as a teacher. He used to teach everything to these children. Now, while the children sat in the rows on either side of the veranda, singing the alphabet or prayer in the chorus. So children used to sit on the floor over there. They used to put some carpet, and they used to sit over there. And just teacher used to roam in the middle by telling the prayers and all the things, and the children used to just repeat him in the chorus voice. My grandmother sat inside reading the scriptures. Meantime, the grandmother used to sit in the temple while reading the scriptures, means all the religious holy books, right? When we both had finished, so when the job of these two people, the grandmother as well as this boy Khushwant Singh, right, we would together. This time the village dogs would meet us at the temple gate. So the dogs were also in the habit. They must be knowing that certainly grandmother would come out and she would have so many chapatis for them. So they followed us to our home, growling and fighting with each other for the chapatis we threw them. So grandmother used to bring so many of chapatis that for the whole way she used to throw them, and those dogs, they used to growl and fighting with each other for getting more chapatis. Right? Next paragraph. When my parents were comfortably settled in the city, they sent for us. So, but after this, when the parents were settled in the city, they called these two people. That was the turning point in our friendship. So here Khushwant Singh is saying that was a turning point, because the change has come in the life of the boy and this grandmother. Although we shared the same room, so they were given the same room to sleep, but my grandmother no longer came to school with me. So here the school education, the cities are different. I used to go to an school, English school, in the motor bus. So in the schools, as we know, in the city, all the children go by the school bus, right? There were no dogs in the street. So here the dogs were not found, and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house. So she has replaced those dogs with the birds, and she used to feed them during the lunch hours. As the years rolled by, we saw less of each other. Children, it always happens with all the children. When they grow, they have the burden of syllabus. They all are having the responsibilities upon their head for their career. So hardly they get time to talk to their grandparents. For some time, she continues to wake me up and get me ready for the school. For some time, she tried to continue with the same habit as she used to do in the villages. But when I came back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught, right? I would tell her the English words. So when he used to come from the school, grandmother always asked what you have studied there. So this boy was so innocent that he always told her all the subjects which he used to study in the school. English subject and all the little things of science, social studies, geography, maths, the law of gravity, the Archimedes principles and all. And the world around means geography. This made her unhappy. So she was not happy at all, because she thought that this is all useless, because these schools are not giving any religious education to these children and they are not becoming anything. So they taught us in the school and was distressed that they were no teaching about the God and the scriptures, as I told you. One day I announced that we were given music lessons. So this boy declared that today I studied music in the school. She was very distressed. Children, in those days, it was considered that films, acting, music, dance. This is a very low type of subjects, and this is not considered for the high class or middle class community. Right? To her music, it is a lewd association. In those days, beggars used to sing to please kings and the queens. You might have seen many beggars. They were holding the harmonium and pleasing the public and begging. Right? So it was the monopoly of the harlots, means prostitutes and beggars, and not for the meant for the general folk. So she thought that this is not for gentle people, right? And she said nothing. After this, she understood that here her wish will not be followed by anybody. So she remained quiet. Her silence meant disapproval. She rarely talked to me after that. So she understood that here this boy will not follow her own wishes. So she remained quiet. Right? Next paragraph. When I went up to university, I was given a room by my own. So as soon as the boy grew, the parents also gave him the separate room. So here the common link of friendship was snapped. Certainly, the boy was hardly getting the time to talk to grandmother. My grandmother accepted her seclusion with resignation. So she understood that now I have to remain quiet, and this boy will not having the time to talk to me. She rarely left her spinning wheel and to talk to anybody. So what did she do? She started the practice of spinning all the time and reciting prayers. As I told you, she was very religious also. Only in the afternoon she got relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows, the habit which she has developed. So in the lunch break, she used to just feed the sparrows while she sat in the veranda, breaking the bread crumbs into the little bits. Hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating the veritable bedlam of chirpings. So many birds, hundreds of birds used to come by making so much of chirpings, which was not understood by anybody. It was a bedlam of chirpings, means bedlam is the word which we can't understand. Too much of noise, right? So the bird used to come, they used to make so much of noise. Some came and perched on her legs. Perch means sat. So some birds used to sit upon her legs, some used to sit upon her shoulder, some used to sit upon her head even. She smiled, but she did not say anything. She did not shoot them away. It used to be the happiest half an hour for her. So it was the most relaxing time in her life at that time. When I decided to go to abroad for further studies, so after the university, the boy had to go to abroad for further studies and higher studies. I was sure that my grandmother would be upset. So this boy was having the idea, certainly my grandmother will be very upset. I would be away for 5 years because this boy was going to the abroad for a very long time, and it was a time of 5 years, right? And at this age, nobody can say what will happen, right? But my grandmother could. She was not even sentimental. My grandmother was very bold. She was very much determined. She was a very, very strong lady. She was not at all emotional. She came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk or show any emotion. The grandmother was available at the station also, but she did not say anything. She was quiet, right? Her lips were moved in prayer. So it was again, she was busy in inaudible prayer, and her mind was lost in prayer. She was busy in some religious thoughts. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. She was again just showing the beads of her rosary. She was just holding the beads of rosary and praying to God. Silently, she kissed upon my forehead, and when I left, I cherished the moist imprint as perhaps the last physical contact between us. So when they were departing, the grandmother, she kissed upon the forehead of this boy, right? So this boy, he did not wipe it out because he thought maybe when I will come back, certainly I will not find this grandmother on this earth. So he did not wipe. He kept on feeling the love, the affection of this grandmother upon his forehead, right? Then, but that was not so. After 5 years, I came back home and was met by her at the station. So after 5 years, when this boy returned to India. Even then, the grandmother was at the station to receive him. He did not look a day older. Again, he was looking the same. She still had no time for words. She was not talking to anybody. And while she clasped me in her arms, I could hear her reciting her prayers. So when she embraced this boy in her arms, at that time also the boy could listen the prayers. She was chanting the prayers. Even on the first day of my arrival, her happiest moments were with her sparrows. So when the boy came at that time also, when she came back to home, that time also she again fed the sparrows with her frivolous rebukes, means lovely abuses, I must say this, right? So she fed longer and with frivolous rebukes, means she just again entertained her time with the birds, and she made so many rebukes to them, right? Then after this, in the evening, a change came over her. So these people were astonished to see the behavior of the grandmother, because in the evening, what did she do? She did not pray. For the very first time in his life of this Khushwant Singh, that he found that his grandmother was not praying. She collected or invited the women from her neighborhood, right? And she just took out the old diaper, little means all torn drum, and she started the singing. She was singing the songs which were used to be sung by the ladies when their husband used to come back from the war, right? And for many hours she kept on beating that sagging skin of the dilapidated drum. Means the skin was all torn. The music was not good. Even then she was beating that drum because she was too much happy, and sang the homecoming of the warriors. We had to persuade her to stop to sing. So we all tried her to stop, not to sing anymore, but she did not listen because she was overjoyed. That was the first time since I had known her that she did not pray. So Khushwant Singh is saying that for the first time in her life, she did not pray as I have seen her. The next morning, she was taken ill. So the result of this overexertion was that she became ill. It was a mild fever, and doctors told us that it would go. So it happens with all the old people when they overstrain their body. Certainly the fever is always found upon their body, and the doctor said it would go. But my grandmother thought that her end was near. So grandmother understood that now she is going to die. She said that because only for the few hours before the close of her chapter, she did not pray. She omitted to pray, so she was not going to waste any more time talking to us. So she denied to talk to anybody, and she said that I will not waste my time, and I will not talk to anybody, and I will start praying. After this, we protested, but she ignored our protest. She lay peacefully in the bed praying and telling her beads even before we could suspect. Her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. So children, she passed away because she understood that her end was near. So she was praying at the time, and she was not wasting her time to talk to anyone, right? A peaceful pallor spread on her face. So she became dead, and ultimately the peace had come upon her face. She was not a living body, and we knew that she was dead. So they understood that the grandmother was passed away. We lifted her off the bed and, as a customary, laid her on the ground, which is a custom in all the houses. When the person passes away, we used to just lay him on the ground, right? Covered with the red shroud. Shroud means the cloth which we used to cover to the dead body, right? After the few hours of mourning, mourning means lamenting, we left her alone to make the arrangements for her funeral. So they have to just do the last rites also. So they went to buy so many things for the funeral, and in the evening we went to her room. So when they came back, it was at evening time, the sun was reflecting all over the veranda, and the crude stretcher means the wooden frame upon which the dead body is laid. right? To take her to be cremated, they have to just take this body for the cremation. The sun was blazing, it was setting, and it was blazing all around and halfway of the courtyard. So they were having the huge house, and the whole courtyard was shining and the blazing with the sunlight. All over the veranda and her room, right up where she lay dead and the stiff wrapped in the red shroud, the body was covered, and they were ready to take the body for the cremation. At that time, thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. So many sparrows came, they sat scattering all over the floor. There was no chirping. But you can find the difference. When Dadi Maa was living, the birds used to make so much of sound. But now they understood that Dadi Maa is no more, right? Nature also responds to the person's love. They understood that she was no more, so they were not chirping, they were not happy. They were all sad. They just came to pay their tribute to Dadi Maa, and we felt sorry for the birds and my mother. So they thought that because they have come for the feeding and again enjoying the breadcrumb, so the mother of this boy, what did she do? She just took out some bread and just tore them into the pieces, broke them into the pieces and just threw on the ground. But as the grandmother used to do, but there threw it to them, but then the way Dadi Maa used to do, but the sparrows took no notice of the bread. But those sparrows had not come to eat the food. They only came to pay their tribute for this dead body or the grandmother. When we carried my grandmother's corpse off, corpse means dead body. So when the dead body was taken away, or it was taken, they flew away quietly. All the birds, they flew away quietly without making any sound and without eating any breadcrumbs thrown by the author's mother. Next morning, the sweeper swept the breadcrumbs into the dustbin. So the next morning, those breadcrumbs were taken away by the sweeper.